I think so.
Yeah, that is the fish, Jordan.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Kind of late to doing the intro, but I'm here with Josh. He's upstream fishing. We started at a spot this morning, about an hour from here. Just didn't go like we thought. It looked really good on Google Maps. Looked really good in person. Just no fish. We were about to drive like another hour and a half to another spot, and on the way I seen another spot on Google Maps, and we're like, let's just stop by, see what it looks like. Looks way better in person than on Google Maps. So we gave it a go. Right off the bat, I looked down and there was a bullhead covered in mud on the bank. Just thought it was dead. I seen it breathing. Luckily enough, I had a cat rod with me. Hooked him, dropped it right in front of this waterfall off the current, and it got hammered right away. I didn't realize what was happening and pulled it right out of its mouth. So, bullhead's still alive, dropped him back down. Josh has caught a couple things on Nightcrawlers upstream, and I've had a couple bites on the Nightcrawler as well, but it's supposed to get real hot today, but it's still pretty early. Stay tuned, hopefully we can catch whatever attacked that bullhead, and have a Nightcrawler out on Carolina rig as well as the time goes. I'm trying to make some time go by, but stay tuned. Let's have fun doing some creek fishing, exploring new places during the day, hanging out with Josh. Let's do it.
That's a sign. Yeah. Or last last night or something.
That's crazy. Well, we caught something.
Yeah.
With your hands.
He definitely has a hook mark in him.
Does he?
Yeah.
In his back?
Yep.
Someone's probably trying this morning, man.
Do you hook him through the mouth?
Moving water, I normally do, yeah.
Where should I toss this little dude?
Probably the heavy current.
Like right out in front?
Yeah. Try to find somewhere you can pop it up over in that area and just throw it right in front. Probably deeper than fuck.
Yeah. Like maybe 10.
So spot number 2 might be.
It's looking up.
Morning started out pretty weird already.
Yeah.
we were in town, leaving town. There was a car just parked in the middle of the road sideways. And then there was just a naked dude on a roundabout. Someone was already calling the cops, so we just kept going. Spot number 1 kind of sucked. We were getting ready to drive an hour to spot number 2, and George was like, let's just pull off the side of the road and try this. Maybe there's a naked dude here, too. very respectable size channel.
I think so.
Yeah, that is a fish, Jordan. There's a flathead sitting right in there.
Oh!
That was a flathead.
Yeah. That was right huge. There. Yep.
Yeah, it was a flathead.
I dropped it right here.
Yeah.
But my line was over there.
Get it back in there.
What the hell? That was huge.
We're staying here.
I don't know. I didn't know what to do. I thought it was snagged.
From my angle, it was very obviously a...
I was pulling on him. Okay.
Did he even do anything to your pole?
So my line had drifted down, so I thought the whole thing drifted down. It was on that metal piece kind of going like this. So I thought it was stuff was getting on it, but it was actually... The line was back here. So it was like this.
Random bullhead you found on the ground. Oh almost just turned into a flathead, dude.
Okay.
And at this rate, I think it might turn into a flathead.
Yeah.
Looks like whoever was fishing down here was just fishing kind of the calmer stuff back there, but that is where you want to be, Jor-Dan. That is where you want to be. All right, so big channel.
Possibly a flathead.
There's nothing else that way.
No. And it had marks on it. It was just straight down too, where I dropped it.
Yep.
Seemed like a good spot.
They're sitting there right at the base, man, waiting for food. That was crazy, dude.
Yeah. There was a way that up, I did it.
I think, yeah, it would have been better if you would have caught it for sure.
I just didn't know what was happening.
It's a good sign.
Yeah, I wish we had more live bait.
Yeah. Maybe if I can, I'm going to try to catch a tiny channel or two. They'll work just as well as bullheads. Flatheads are getting ready to spawn. They'll kill a channel on site as well.
Mm-hmm.
They got a flathead just ate. The flathead just ate. Yep. It's going.
Going?
Yep.
Don't screw it up this time, George. Get down.
Circle. Yep. He went underneath.
Turned around and my line just went, and then it just started spooling underneath. He was way under there, like 2 feet.
I'm gonna rig up my casters pole just to be ready for when we catch the 90 channel. Hold it up under there, Ed.
Yep. I had him on, see what else he's doing. He was not good at setting.
I mean, you could set it up in the pole holder.
Where it's tight?
Yeah. Takes away the nerves a little bit, you know?
Yeah, because I fail every time.
It just, it's a nerve-wracking thing.
It is, because like, you know what it is usually.
Yeah.
That was straight down again. Like, I moved it from out there to, like, more right here. And I turned around, and I seen the line jump, and that usually means something happened.
Yeah.
And then I could just see my spool.
I think your crawler's getting hit or dragging.
It was getting hit, but I kind of just ignored it.
Ah, screw the crawler.
Yep. Screw that pole, screw the crawler.
hooked up.
On what?
Carp.
Carp?
Hooked up. Carp.
Carp?
Yeah. Oh no. Yeah. Pretty big. I might have to come over there. Yep.
How fast these look, like 20?
15. As much. Thank you.
Shoot, Jordan, I was gonna eat him. Oh shit, Jordan's on fire. No more bamboozling you, Jordan. Carp. I thought it was a channel. Bigger than the last one.
out. Stay. Look at that thing. Thing's freaking awesome. That's a big boy.